guys, to another video about hosting a static website in Amazon S3. And the idea here, you have a static website and you want just to put it in S3 in order to serve your customer. So let us get into it. We will first create a bucket. Now, let me give this bucket a name, like website, and I will give it the date of today, just to give it a unique name in the AWS region, US East 1. Now, the new changes in Amazon S3 console is basically this object ownership. So in the previous version, we don't have access list enabled or object ownership. So we need to make sure to finish this lap successfully to enable access list for the objects. And we give that the ownership of the bucket to be able to change the object ownership. And then we will block all public access. We will disable that. Then we acknowledge. And then we can enable the bucket versioning from here. You could also add tag if you want. And you could also add a server-side encryption if you are storing a sensitive data in this bucket. Now click on Create Bucket. The next thing is to select the bucket you just created. And then go to the properties and all the way down, go to static website hosting and enable. And once you enable this, you can basically point out that this is to host a static website and the name of the indexed document that you are going to use in this website. In my case, it's going to be HTML. You could also specify an error page just in case if there is any issue on your website. You can return to your customer an error message, click on Save Changes. Once you do that, you will be able to get a new link for your website. And you can see now it's giving me 403 forbidden, which means we don't have permission to view the website content as of yet. The next step, we have like a demo application, a demo static website that I'm going to share with you in the description. To try this lab out, you just click on upload, add files, and let me select a small index.html file with a JavaScript and a styling file. Just to click open and then click on upload. The next thing is going to be after you upload the files, you need to select them and then you go to action and then make public via ACL. Now, if you did not select ACL object in the creation of the bucket, you will find this option not available. So what you could do is to make it happen is basically to go to the bucket itself. And from the bucket, there is a permission and the permission, there is an object ownership here. You can edit that in order to basically be able to make your object public. The next thing is to go now to the bucket itself, to the URL that was given to us in S3, and refresh the page. And you will see now I have a nice static website with a nice map where I basically offer my customer to visit my business. Thank you so much for seeing this video and see you in the next one.